All right, I've got just a quick side story first. The trip got off to a rough start for me. After we flew from LA to Taipei, we were sitting waiting for that last flight, and I checked my Facebook, and there was, y'all know about the shooting in Colorado. That was my hometown, and it obviously hit close to home, and so it was all over Facebook, you know, and I don't think I really got a chance to deal with it until really this morning, and so all that is coming out, and I want to thank you all that that have been praying for that and that will continue to do so, and as I've just wrestled with that this morning, I found a huge, I don't know what, in my heart for the shooter. It's obviously an awful situation, but this is just a difficult thing that's in our hearts. That the Bible says that God desires every man and woman to come to repentance, to come to a knowledge of Him. And I'm going to confess that's the last thing on my heart about Him. And so I want you guys to continue to pray for the victims and the people over there, but also to pray for this guy. That in the midst of whatever is going on in his mind, that Jesus would just speak through loud and clear to that, because he is bigger and more powerful and stronger than any of that. And so I would just ask that you guys continue to pray and for my heart as well towards that, because right now it's not good. And so sorry for that. But in Cambodia, I want you guys to know that the pictures and the descriptions and everything that we've heard it described up until now is spot on. Like, it could not have been a better description. And the stuff that you're going to hear today is not an exaggeration. It's real. We witnessed stuff over there that miracle-wise that we do not see over here. And I'm convinced now that it's because we don't look for it. That the distractions and all of that stuff hide what God desires to do. And all of that stuff is real and active, and God is moving big time over there. In our second church, there was a long drive, dirt roads, you know, winding back through this just rice paddies all over. And we take this left turn, and right here on the right side is a Buddhist temple that just has many, many acres devoted to it. I mean, just huge temples there, and there's monks walking all around. Everywhere in Cambodia, there's monks walking all around, but at this temple, it's just huge. And then probably 50 yards past that is our second church. And so there's just Buddhism is influenced all around it. And the second day that we were there, Pastor Lon came up, and he doesn't speak any English, and so through our interpreter, he asked that we pray for him. He's new as a pastor. He's a young guy, and his prayer was this, that there are people in his community that come to him with questions all the time about Buddhism, come with him with questions all the time about truth, about what's a lie, about what's real, about what's not. And he has found it incredibly difficult to stand firm through all of that, just all of the opposition that he's facing with a huge Buddhist temple 50 yards from his church, and all of the people that are devoted to that are fighting against Christ. And he just asked us for prayer, and that God would guide him and lead him and give him the words, give him the strength to stand firm in the midst of all of that. And so having that as our foundation of Pastor Lon was incredible. And as we got to spend the week, he's constantly smiling, like not in that picture, of course, but smiling all the time, you know, and it's not one of those smiles that that I've got nothing, but I'm still happy, you know, that we hear about all the time. It's one of those smiles that as he sees his children of the church, as he sees the adults of the church hearing the gospel, that he is overjoyed. Whenever anybody was talking or not listening to the gospel being shared or to our stories about Jesus, he would tell them to be quiet and kind of push them towards the front so that they could hear every word about Jesus that was being said. And as that was happening, he was just grinning from ear to ear. And so I ask that you guys, just L-A-N or L-U-N, I don't even know how they spell it, Pastor Lon, super easy to remember, pray for his guidance and for that he would stand firm in the faith, and that when questions are brought to him, that he would relay truth, that God would give him the answers that he doesn't know, and that the people there that are struggling with Buddhism versus Christ, that answer would just be crystal clear because of Christ's power in the lives of that church and through the words and smile and just everything that Pastor Lon is. So thank you all for your prayers throughout the trip and for your continued prayers for the people in Cambodia. Thank you.